going to discuss about Fermat's theorem. At first I will see Euler's theorem, and in my previous video I have discussed Euler's theorem elaborately. Okay, so at first see my previous video. In this video I have given link in my description box. Just see the statement of the Euler's theorem. If n be a positive integer and GCD of an equal to 1, then by Euler's theorem a to the power phi n congruent to 1 modulo n. Okay, this is the Euler's theorem. And what is Fermat's theorem? Fermat's theorem is applicable when p is only a prime number. Okay, we all of us know phi p equal to p minus 1. Why p minus 1? I have discussed in my previous video, so it will be clear when you see my previous video. Okay, then by Euler's theorem a to the power p minus 1 is congruent to 1 modulo p, where a is not a multiple of p. Okay, let's see one example of Fermat's theorem. Okay, find the remainder of 4 to the power 1 log with modulo 19. Notice GCD of 4 and 19 equal to 1. Okay, then by Fermat's theorem we can write 4 to the power 18 congruent to 1 with modulo 19. Okay, then 1 log equal to, by division algorithm, (5555 × 18+10). Okay, that means 4 to the power 100, 1 lakh. We can write it by this algorithm: 4 to the power 18 to the power 5555 × 4 to the power 10. And by Euler's theorem, 4 to the power 18 congruent to 1. This is congruent to 1 to the power 5555 × 4 to the power 10. Okay, this is congruent to 4 to the power 10 with modulo 19, here also modulo 19. Okay, now we apply power. We all of us know 4 to the power 1 equal to 4, then 4 square equal to 16, 16 congruent to minus 3 with modulo 19. Okay, we all of us know if a congruent to b, then a to the power k congruent to b to the power k. Then by these rules we can write 4 to the power 4 congruent to 9 modulo 19. Okay, similarly we can write 4 to the power 8 congruent to 81 with modulo 90. And we also know the property, if A congruent to B modulo n and C congruent to D modulo n, then AC congruent to BD modulo n. Okay? Then we can write 4 to the power n 10 equal to 4 to the power 8 times 4 to the power 2. By the rules of product, we can be write it, this is congruent to 5 times minus 3 modulo 19, okay, and this is equal to minus 15, and minus 15 modulo 19 congruent to minus 15 congruent to 4 modulo 19. Okay, that means the remainder will be 4. This is the answer. Now I will discuss one question of CSR NET. Let's see the question. A belongs to any integer B such that A equal to sum of two non-zero number B square plus C square, where B and C belongs to non-zero integer. Then A cannot be written as option 1 PD square, where D belongs to Z and P is a prime with P congruent to 1 modulo 4. Option 2, PD square, where D belongs to integer and P is prime with P congruent to 3 modulo 4. Option 3, PQD square, where D belongs to integer and PQ are prime number with P congruent to 1 modulo 4, Q congruent to 3 modulo 4. Okay. Option 4, PQD square, where D belongs to integer, PQ are distinct prime, where PQ congruent to 3 modulo 4. And this question depend on new topic, Fermat's sum of two square theorem. Okay, let's see the statement of the theorem. We can write any odd prime number as sum of two square even only if those prime number will congruent to 1 modulo 4. Okay. As for example, 17 congruent to 1 with modulo 4. So we can write it by square. Then 17 equal to 16 plus 1. That means 17 can be write as sum of 2 square. Have you understood? Okay. Also, we can write any number in form of sum of 2 square if its congruent does not exist, as 3 modulo 4. Okay, this is the theorem. Now come back the option 1. Option 1 equal to PD square, where D belongs to any integer and P is any prime number with P congruent to 1 modulo 4. This is depend on this theorem. Let's verify the option 1. Here P congruent to 1 modulo 4. Since P congruent to 1 modulo 4, Then by theorem, there exist B and C non-zero integer which is such that P equal to B square plus C square, where BC belongs to non-zero integer. Okay, now multiply with the both side d square, then it will be p d square equal to b d square plus c d square. Okay, then we can write is it b dash whole square plus C dash whole square. Then P D square can be written as B dash whole square plus C dash whole square, where B dash whole square equal to B square D square and C dash whole square equal to C square D square. Okay. Then P dash square is a number. P D square is a number that can be written as sum of two square. Okay, that means here the question, A cannot be written as P D square, where A equal to sum of two square. By that solution, A can be written as sum of two square. So first option is incorrect option. Okay, because here A cannot be written as, here has told A cannot be, but in the first option, A always can be written as sum of two non-zero integer square. Okay, let's come back second option. The second option equal is PD square, where D be any integer and P is prime number with P congruent to 3 modulo 4. Okay, here given P congruent to 3 modulo 4. Let P equal to 3, then it satisfies this congruent, and D equal to 1, then PD square equal to 3. Do you think this PD square can be written as B square plus C square? If you put 1, 1, it will be 2. How you can get 3? Have you understood? If we have takes BC greater than 1, then their sum B square plus C square always will be greater than 3. That means this is cannot possible. How can we retain any number 3 sum of 2 square? This is never possible. Okay, so option 2 is right option, because in option 2 has told A cannot be written as PD square. Okay, right. Now let's come back third option. Third option is PQD square, where D belongs to any integer and PQ are prime number with P congruent to 1 modulo 4, Q congruent to 3 modulo 4. Okay, let P equal to 5, Q equal to 3, D equal to 1. Then P Q D square equal to 15. Do you think this can be written as B square plus C square? If you choose 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, every cases 15 cannot be possible. Okay. And if any number greater than 3, then B square plus C square will be greater than 15. Okay, that means this is not possible. If you put 2, 3, this is also cannot be possible. If you place 3 here, that means 3, 3, this is also not possible. Therefore, PQD square cannot be written as sum of 2 square method. So, option 3 also correct option. A cannot be written as PQD square, where P congruent to 1 modulo 4, Q congruent to 3 modulo 4. Okay? Here given PQ congruent to 3 modulo 4. If you choose P equal to 3, Q equal to 3, then P and D equal to 1, then PQ D square equal to 9. Do you think this can be written as B square plus C square? If you put 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 2, then the sum cannot be 9. And if any number bigger than 3, then B square plus C square will be greater than strictly 9. Okay? That means we cannot get any number whose sum can be written as B square plus C square. So option 4 also correct. But if you know this statement, then you can solve this question by step forward. Okay?